Hello. What's up, boys and girls? Give me a second. We're getting set up. Live. With some online poker, hey? Been a little bit. Ew, what's this song? What is this horrible music? Is it all just dubstep? It's just a little too intense, mate. Excuse me. What's up, everybody? What the hell's happening? How are we doing? Tournaments didn't crash? I just jumped in tournaments, like, I saw the tournaments were crashing, but I just jumped in some games, like, a little while ago. Everything's great. What's up, Yakuri?
Kmart, let's go. Kmart, let's go. Kmart, let's go. Kmart, let's go.
Let's go indeed. Okay, really good flop here. He's really short. I guess we win one big blind bet. Scoop it up. Ryan Broad, everybody's piling in. I'm just sending out the socials, guys, and we got five tables up already. I am excited. I'm excited. Yo, why is this tiny little cough here? It's a pretty good flop. Ari's under the gun, he flats cutoff. Yo, really looking forward to streaming today. I guess we should just c-bet multi-way, right?
Run good time.
It's kind of the thing we should just do. Could play check. I wouldn't hate it, but Sully Church AR GG shit the bed today. It's funny. I just jumped on and everything's good for me. But yeah, apparently it crashed, right? So this player's playing a fair number of hands. Not too much we lose to. Kings, queens, aces. Basically not going to be there ever. Sets of five, sets of threes. I think we're just stacking here. We just want all the value from like queen 10, queen jack, queen nine suited. Don't think this is real. It is real. It is real. Yeah, I had a little MMA training this morning. River is like pretty bad. Not worried about the four. The backdoor flush a little concerning. The river is pretty bad. Checkmate. Nice. Queen 10, queen jack, right?
Kmart, let's go. Kmart.
Wow, how does he have kings here? So sick. I don't get stacked. I never thought he had kings. Interesting. I don't wanna love again. Really big dabs. What's up, my brother? So we're in five tournaments here. 500, 100, 177, etc., etc. Dude, I thought I was totally better. I was a little sick recently, but I just still have this lingering cough. To be a call blind on blinds. They play limp, as long as they're not limp trapping. Can we just have a nice hit today? What a hit. What a fucking hit. Think we can have a nice hit today? I think we might actually. Let's load up a little focused playlist here. Okay, so it's $100 turbo. Holy shit, it's Kevin! Putting on the Kmart hoodie right now. I know I need to get mine on. I have my Kmart shirt on right now. Dude, it's been a little while, bro. I went to Japan. I'm just going to shove here. This guy's playing a lot of hands. Yeah, he's opening with this guy being short, which is like a little concerning. But I think shoving ace-9 suited with fold equity is just going to print really hard for so many reasons. And I like spots that print. He doesn't snap call, but he does call. He has a very good hand. He has a very, very, very good hand. We bust. What about here?
Hell yeah, let's go. BTW, thank you so much for the hoodie. I love it.
Oh, you're welcome, man. Gooberman with 46 months. Ryan Braun with 35. Matty Cakes with 26. Sully with 38. Appreciate you guys. A bunch of legends. What's up, Brett? Brett's in the building. We totally miss here. We just have ace high. Probably not going to be the best hand. Do I want to rep like delayed bet with like king 10, ace 10? It's not really enough hands. We got to get a 1K today. We got to play the 1K mystery bounty, right? Actually, let's play the 215 Sunday heater first. There's a 1K mystery bounty. I'll definitely jump in that. Let's jump in the 215 first here. Kmart, you saved me from watching the Pro Bowl. Don't they play flag football in the Pro Bowl now? Yeah, the Pro Bowl's not really top tier entertainment, is it? Sunday. Dude, I have so much shit to tell you guys. I went to Japan. I've been in an interesting stage of life. Things are good, but just recalibrating. I'm being very introspective.
Crush it today, you dog.
Trying to figure out goals and stuff. Raise, take it down there. This is our main event. This is the 500. A little bit of a slow start. We still have 60 bigs. It's tons. We're starting the 54 with the bounty. Or the 105 is a good start. Let's just play some good solid no limit hold'em, shall we? I limp small blind, he checks big blind. I think betting one big blind here is kind of effective. We're supposed to basically never fold, and they do click fold. Having two overcards to the four, if we're supposed to like find some optimism here, can definitely come from that. We can barrel on like a six, a seven. An ace isn't really that great. We're probably not betting many of our ace highs on the flop. And now our card removal is like pretty bad. So I think we'll just check. This is fun, man. I haven't played a full online session in a while, and these are all really good tournaments. Rams Ray, what's up, brother? Yeah, King Queen here. This is a 105 mystery bounty. No bounties in play till the money. Could call, could three bet. Let's talk to our old buddy, Eugene. What's up, my brother? 80. We're definitely going to three bet an 80. Don't have to three bet very large. Our old buddy Eugene. We got 4-bet shoved, which is sad. Hey, welcome everybody. Dude, life is good, man. Life is good. Not gonna lie. I know you guys don't want to hear this. You're like, where's the stream? Where's the content? There's been some content coming out, but bro, I've just been trying to figure some self out. I guess soul searching is like, I mean, maybe that's too aggressive. I got aces here. Come on. Pocket aces in the cutoff. Give me some action. That is some action. More. I want more. This is for a nice 36K. Unders and suited cards. 3-1 favorite. Not the best flop. There are worse. 81%. We lose with the aces. We lose. That is super... super rude, actually. No problem. Didn't have that many chips. Kind of an annoying spot here. Don't think I can fold ace high backdoor flush draw, but I can. Dude, let's hit something today. How do I lose with the blades there? Four is here, probably the bottom of the flat in range. I think we can fold deuces and threes. I think fours and fives will get in there with the flat. All the big guaranteed tournaments, 10 a.m. certain times were canceled. Yeah, shoot, man. Dude, I've been a little bit out of the scene, bro. Like, I deleted, like, Twitter, Instagram. I still post, but I don't really consume anymore. But I hear people are feuding, like, Berkey and fucking Doug, and it's a bit of a shitstorm in the poker world. Hustler's having more drama. Ooh, full house. Now, this is the kind of flop we're looking for. Is everything good, guys? Levels look good. Screen looks good. Okay, this is a beautiful situation. 40 bigs deep. We play pure call. Of course, a 10 is a bad card. Or, like, let's say they have queen 10 and a queen comes off. But, I mean, there's no explanation here. We just actually have the super nuts. Him betting on this board is, like, pretty encouraging as well. He goes small again, which is actually quite concerning. If he is like queen-queen or queen-ten suited, not many combos, he probably would choose a small size. I think we just play call, just in case he has like ace-king with a club that's like dead. excuse me. Really apologize for the cough if it comes in. Dude, I've been really sick too. I think if he has a flush, he might just size up on turn. Small bet can also be like ace-queen. It can be all these hands. I'm all in, buddy. How many full houses does he have? He never has 6-6, so he's queen-10 suited, two combos. He's one combo of quads, but they could probably check the flop. He has three combos of queen-queen. I don't know why I'm counting full house combos. Like, obviously, I'm all in. That is no good. Boom! Snapped it in there. That maybe he might size up flushes on the turn. That low jack peel. Yes, sir. He's criticizing the old 4-4 call preflop. It's a pair, bro. What are you talking about? Pair of fours. I will also return with the LOL. He laughs and I will laugh as well. What were you doing in Japan? Traveling, man. Traveling. Give me 1 second.
GLGL Kev.
So I'll tell you guys like this. First of all, let me send out a tweet. Could potentially 3-bet this sometimes. But versus a wreck, we go a little more pure linear. This is a really good flop defending out of the big blind. I'm going to lead. Just kind of have the whole world here. Oh, wow. That's kind of excessive. That's really, really, really excessive. What the fuck is that? Should we just gamble? Let's think about it. If he has ace high flush draw, it's pretty bad. Like, let's say his queen 10 of spades is pretty all right. If he has a... Why would he... I just am so confused. Yeah, I don't know. Shall we go for the stack?
Sure, gamble.
Okay, we're actually a favorite. What an interesting play by him. This is for a lot of chips. No, ace high wins a 350 big blind pot. Ace high wins a 350 big blind pot. Re-enter. We got it in good. We did get it in good with the equity. Okay, he raised blind on blind. This is the 54. I call, flop, flush draw. He bets flop, I call. Bets half pot on turn. I'm going to call. We get there with the nizzles. And hopefully, because he barrels turn on such a connected board, he just has a 9. This is a 54 bounty hunter. I did get a bounty. It really does feel like he has a 9, which is great for me. Queen Bee, what's up? Charlie with the prime sub. Kyle as well. Thank you, bro. I have the nuts here. For him to triple barrel this board is very strong. It's almost always a 9. Boom! $12.50, 150 big blind pot. Chips are flying. Chips are definitely flying. Let's jump up here. Pocket 9s and 17 bigs. It's so funny that he had ace king there and I just have this combo draw. We played a 400 big blind pot. Just don't think I'm ever folding. Okay. I have pair. He is ace high. Set. Let's go. Let's chip up and have a hit. Hey, Curry, I'm chilling today trying to recover from a second nasty cold virus in the last month. So crazy. Your Curry, Jenna, same thing. I got really sick on Christmas, got better, and then after my Japan travels, after I went to Japan, I came back and got really sick as well, which is really, really quite strange. But I guess I was pushing myself really hard, not sleeping enough, international travel. Like, it kind of all makes sense, right? Ace 10 here. We're live on both Twitch and YouTube. I think checking here, we have a hand that probably wants to just see a turn. What do I do here? A raise and a 3-bet. Very strong positions. Ace-queen suited, though. We're just so deep. I can probably play cold call. What is going on here? For a bounty now. Surely I have to be crushed though. 62-87. Let's see if I can fuck this guy up and make him mad again. Let's see if I can get another comment. This guy might spoil the party. He might just spoil the party. He raised button. I defended. Flop goes check, check. He overbets the turn. What the fuck is that? Yo, 5 gifted subs from Cry Me a Turn. Thank you so much. Appreciate that. What's up, dude? 5 gifted on the Twitch streets. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Really appreciate that. Another interesting spot I will fold. He was a little salty. He was a little salty, yeah. Cut off opens. Because he's going to have the offsuit 9s here, I don't really want to 3-bet bluff this too much. But I definitely want to V-pip versus cut off open. Pretty bad board. A really bad gut shot. No clubs, though. The plan today is we're going to chill, we're going to flow, we're going to play good. Hopefully we have some hits. If we don't, that's okay. No pressure, man.
Kmart, you are a true legend. Received my hoodie in the mail. Can't thank you enough.
Oh, you're welcome, man.
Currently in Vegas covering the Super Bowl on Radio Row. Swung nice, by South Point Poker Room last night. Kmart, let's go, Kmart, let's go, Kmart, let's...
Dude, I love the South Point Poker Room. Okay, we're really deep here, so we're going to use the linear three-betting strategy. And we're going to pump it with jacks. Small blind versus cutoff open. Okay, three-bet pot. Obviously a really bad flop for my hand. How's my range doing? It's pretty good. Just considering that we have ace-king, he probably four-bets that a lot. He doesn't really have queens or kings. So although this hand really kind of sucks, I kind of like starting with a bet. And now I actually think I have a really good bluff candidate in a lot of ways. Now I think I have a really good bluff candidate. Like, what does he do with, like, ace-queen versus turn? I have a straight. What are you talking about? I'm not bluffing anymore. I have a straight. I have a straight. I guess we just triple it off. Like, we lose to ace-jack, of course. It's hard for him to find bluffs if we just, I guess we'll just triple it off. Maybe just get sticky with like king 10, king queen. He doesn't snap, which is good, which means we're probably not even chopping. Hey, good pot, good pot. Over here, I think the price is right for the bounty. Hopefully we're just live and, oh, what are you talking about? It's a flip. Flip for a bounty? Ladies, welcome. Welcome back to the stream, girls. I've already had two bounties in this tournament. This will be number three. Let's go. Let's go.
Good luck today. Thank you.
Oh my god, was I muted that whole time? Obviously, I'm rusty. Was I muted the whole time as I was trying to break down this hand? Why I just bluffed it all off? How does he have this hand? How does he 3-bet pre and then he just like check calls flop, min raises turn? That was a fucked up hand. I got out of line and it cost me. Cost me dearly, dearly. Hey, Kevin, I'm your Korean fan. What's up, bro? Dude, I was just in Japan. People, why do you go to Japan? So this is what happened. And it might not make sense to some people, but I actually had a big win in December. I had a really deep run in Bahamas. Massive score. Really good. Winning year last year through some chaos. But then, bro, I was playing poker in January, and it's a unique feeling that I felt. I felt deep disconnection from the game. Deep disconnection in the game and apathy. Like, the game didn't feel like it mattered to me, and it was really dangerous. You know, sometimes when you grind, you get tired, and, like, you can always recover from being tired, but that feeling of apathy, like, this doesn't matter, it felt like the game didn't matter. And I rarely feel that. I rarely feel that, but I felt it in January, and I've only felt that 3 or 4 other times in my poker career. And the thing is, I never listened to it before, and I got fucked up. My 4 biggest downswings ever are when I felt very apathetic to the game and I didn't and I didn't listen. You remember that one time I lost 100K during the WSOP? I was feeling super apathetic, but I just tried to stream through it and I lost 100K. Other instances of downswings are when I should have just like actually taken a break. And so yeah, I had a 75K score in December. I lost about 10K in January, and then I was like, I quickly realized that feeling. I was like, oh, this isn't good. I'm not in a space where I'm going to win right now. So I just peeled back. I went to Japan, took some time off, went and visited my grandmother, who unfortunately is probably near the end of her life. I went and visited like my baby nieces. I went into the world and chilled. I'm going to defend here in the 500. But that feeling of passion, motivation, it's slowly coming back, which is really exciting. And I'm working on some really fun projects. Can I defend off of 35? It's like a little deep to like check raise stack comfortably. I guess we'll just check call with Jack 5. We make a very strange 2-pair in that there's 4 hearts on the board. That's 3.1. You think if he had a really good flush, he would be sizing up to like get it all in the river? I mean, we're definitely calling. Hopefully we boat up. Could this be a bluff with like queen 10, no heart, just trying to get like some non-heart hands to fold? This river's definitely going to reduce his bluffs with his like 10-9, his queen-10, his king-10, his 10-8, yeah. I think I just fold. I can call with flushes and then, I don't know, if he's good enough to get here with like a queen-10 off and then turn the pair into a bluff on this board, I'm going to give him credit, but kind of feels like he has it. Too bad. This 500 isn't going great, but we're going to remain patient. Yeah, so I went to Japan and like I've just been chilling, journaling a ton, meditating a ton, trying to figure things out. I'm obviously very passionate about the game and creating things, and like that's coming back, but just needed a break. I needed a break. And most people are like, yo, like you grind so hard, take a break, like chill, right? But then a lot of people just like do send nasty messages and they're like, stop being a bitch, come play poker. Aces. This is how I can get the 500 tournament going. The 500 bounty encore. Yeah, I just haven't streamed in a long time. We get a classic mute in right away. All right, come after me. I'm opening the button. I can have anything here. I have pocket aces. I have pocket aces and a bounty on my head. You don't come after me. Zuglies. Comes in with a call. Jack 5 deuce. It's pretty dry, right? That was a little bit of an underwhelming amount of action with the aces. Appreciate everybody coming into the stream today. He's rusty, people. Exactly, bro. Exactly. I would maybe consider V-pipping this, but being shallow here is not great in a PKO. I just get to be a little tighter. What a donation? Yeah, when I bluffed it off into the full house. Okay, raise call. I'm going to peel in the big blind. King high spades. I also am most likely to have a deuce here. I have a tier of suited deuces. Probably just play pure check. This card is quite bad. It's very good for both of my opponents. Both of his opening range and the flatting. Kind of just forces me to fold. Why did you turn your 9 into a bluff? I thought it was a good hand to bluff. But again, I might be a little rusty right now, you know? I am going to open this. It's the bottom, but it's always sketchy opening as this short stack in PKOs. Like, people are supposed to come after you. The open has worked. I open hijack. Queen 6 deuce. I have quite nice suits here. I'm going to see about this one a lot. If these two little small cards were a little more connected, I would think my check back percentage goes up, but we bet we take it down. When do you start playing poker? 2014. 10 years ago. I've been a full-time player and content creator for 10 years. Fuck, I'm old. King 6, King 7, a little bit better 3-bet bluffs than King 3. We're just going to defend this one. Could consider lead with some hands. I think King 3 is pretty dusty, though. Did you play the WSOPC in Calgary? Bro, I played like a couple tournaments at the Calgary tournaments, and again, I felt complete apathy and disconnection. I'm like, I just shouldn't be here, and I just knew I needed to take some time off. He plays check back. How aggressive do I want to be with this one? I think we can bet small, get like some like ace jack to fold and like king queen. In theory, you're not really supposed to bet small here. I bet small, and we see a king on the river. And I will pay 3. 3 to win 15. King 10, King Jack, a little bit worrisome. A straight. Wow, what a hand. Okay, over here I open. Pretty good flop. Let's bet. Call in a call. Definitely want to check, just take my equity here. When both players call flop, bricks out. What's up, Deke? 100%. Thanks, brother. Okay, this guy limped pre-flop, so I think we're dealing with a recreational player here. I raised out of position. I think we're gonna bet small. Japan was so cool, man. It was really such a cool country. It's guy seems pretty passive. I hate folding to small bets, but I just feel like there's no good rivers for us. Even his bluffs, Jack 10, Queen 10 have all sorts of equity. Love it, Brett. Thanks, man. Open King Jack in the secret bounty. And we face lead. So interesting he leads this spot. I don't really understand. I continue with most of my range, but King Jack, no hearts, like stone bottom. I guess we just fold. Okay, some good pots, some bad pots. Dude, I have some really fun creative project plans that I'm really, really excited about. I think I have some fun stuff coming up that you guys will really enjoy. Okay, this guy opens UTG8. Defend. Pretty shitty flop for my hands. Jump over here, pocket ladies. Under the gun, this guy looks like an action player. Just off at 21 bigs. Sweet, looks like a pretty good spot. He's rarely going to 3-bet fold, especially with the bounty. And then, nice, this is even better. We get the very juicy cold call, just for sure adding dead money in there. I'm going to shove here. It's less exciting because of the bounty, but I still think it's just going to print, like, really hard. Button opens. Good luck in the 500. I'm all in with the deuces. Folds are great. Flipping is not horrible. Nice. That's great. Okay, here we go. All in here. It's about as good of a spot as you can imagine. He folds and this is beautiful. Dead money. This guy can have whatever. Is the ace 5 offsuit. Couple of biscuits. Couple of napkins. It's really great. Nice double. Andre says, wouldn't it be better to get all in preflop with ace so they can call wider to get the bounty? No, you don't want to just, so you're asking, should I just open shove aces? The answer is definitely no. So this guy's all in for less than a big. Pick up a 9, that's a big. Take our little bit of showdown here. Be a weird spot for him to bluff. take it. Nice, good fold. Jump back over here to ace queen. I think we want to call. Like, shoving and three betting with this hand is a little bit troublesome. When we call in here, we keep in his ace 10, his king queen off, things like this. Let's get to the 500. Pretty scary open spot, but into the big blind, that's really short. Like, I would fold queen 10 here, so this is bottom. Let's have ourselves an open. Okay, this is really good. Then they're just gonna fast play. If somebody has me beat here, I don't think overpairs are gonna be in any situation. So 5, 6s, ace jack, king jack, Just not many hands that we're truly worried about here. If we could get the big blind to put in a like 7-8 or a worse jack or something or a flush draw, that'd be pretty exciting for the bounty. Oh wow. Fuck, I didn't really consider a situation where I could ever fold. This guy calls and this guy shoves. Just never has a worse jack. Wow. This is crazy. He never shoves jack 10 here. It's always like two pair or a draw. And then there's this player behind. Wow, Jesus. I guess I might actually just fold. Like, I bet into four people, I have obviously a massive hand. Call, shove. Just gonna lay it down, I guess, bro. That spot we're either like dead or have to fade like a combo draw. Wow, I was literally like, I'm never folding this hand, and then a situation somehow emerged where I folded the hand. So weird. Does GG carry that you take some breathers away from the table? Dude, GG Poker just wants me to create when I'm ready to create, and they're great, bro. Really understanding sponsor and like. It's nice to be live though. Let's go. Come on. Let's find a hit today. Come on. Dude, I was feeling so much better. Like, I was really sick, but I was feeling so much better. But then I went and did some training this morning. Trying to learn how to fight. I've wanted to learn how to fight for a long time. Not that I'm going to go try to pick some fights. I've never been in a fight in my life. But just to have the skills in those situations. Okay, we're up against our old friend Rocky, who's just wild. We have trip aces. It's a wonderful, wonderful spot. Let's cooler him. Beautiful. I just don't think this guy is going to... how do we want to take it? This is a guy, when he puts money in the middle, I don't really think he's folding. So I will cry a river if he folds. Fuck it, I'll just call. It's going to be 22 in the middle. Again, literally worried about nothing. We will play it this way. I will call. I'm glad I didn't re-raise at any point. We just let him send it off. I was really going to 3-bet the flop, but then I was like, what? Let's just call. It's Rocky. Queen 7 off is a little aggressive there. This guy has doubled me up twice, which is great. Tempted to open for the $35 bounty, but I'll just chill. Yeah, I'm trying to learn how to fight. It was my first session today. I hired this guy. Okay, I've got the ladies in the 500. Ooh, put it in. Fuck. What a good chance for a bounty there. Open it up, John. Open it up. I'm all in. I just don't think I can like make it like four bigs here or five bigs. He should just have to call with a huge portion of his range anyway. I will be sad if they fold, but I am all in with the ladies. Come on, double me up. John. Doesn't super snap it, but we just want the call. Come on. Beautifully, is it the unders? Undercards. Wow, he's super live here. How about a king? We got to fade a 7 and a deuce. We're going to win on most of them. not a deuce. Boom. What a good spot to get the money in. Come on, let's go. Get the let's goes in chat. I know we still have some subs. I haven't streamed in a while. I know we still have some subscribers. I want to see the let's goes. Big time fucking double. And now maybe we get something here too. Shove it in. Fuck, dude. How does he not shove there? Big, big, big time double, guys, in the 500. Lux Kmart, thank you. Andrew, Primary Echo. Pair of eights here. Dad, I had two big pairs in this guy. Somehow I didn't put the money in. It's a very, very good board for me. Either small bet or a big bet. I'm all in here in the 215. I just had 14 blinds. We got called from a pretty bad position. Yo, we got a raid from Raf as well. What's up, man? Yo, I appreciate that. At least we're live here. And now we're close to dead. Yo, welcome in, Raiders. Hi, my name is Kevin. Just firing up a Sunday stream. Welcome in. I hope you had a good stream with Raf. About to jump in the 1K. We'll just choose small size here. I'm going to jump in the 1K mystery bounty. 1K mystery bounty. Good luck in the 1K. Okay, I got kings here. I'm going to choose a non-all-in size, which looks pretty strong. Yeah, welcome in, Raiders. Thank you, Raf. Appreciate that. This is the 105 mystery bounty. Snap calls. Great. Shallow stack to pot size ratio here. Not worried about anything, really. We have king-king with the diamond. And on this turn, I will just shove. That'll be all in. Nice pot. Okay, raise here, big blind defense. Just go third. Our hand is really bad on queen small small. How do we do for bluffing here? It's pretty bad. Really want a diamond most of the time. And we don't want a seven. When I bluff here, I need him to have like 6-7 that just folds, right? Just yield. Could have a three that gets counterfeit. I feel like I need to bluff now. I do feel like I need to bluff now. What am I repping? Like jacks, tens? I'm not repping many hands. This feels so shitty. But I feel like I just can't check back eight. Oh, it worked! It worked! It felt like a really silly kind of bluff, but I feel like I had to try. I had to try. He raised. I think I will start bluffing here. Kmart, any merch drops coming soon? No, we're still getting rid of season one merch. I gave away my entire merch store. I lost so much money on it, but I was just like, it made so many people happy. I made some Instagram posts. Guys, we got some nice stacks here now. We got a nice stack here. We're back in business in the 500. Doing really good here in the mystery bounty. Doing good here in the 54. And we just jumped in. The main man. We just jumped in here. Sven, what's up, brother? How you doing, bro? And we got fresh stack in the 1K mystery bounty. Let's raise in the 1K. Queen 7 is very aggressive there. Definitely. It's very, very, very aggressive. We got some nice stacks. Not deep enough to set mine. Happy to see you back. What's the most memorable part of the trip? So I was walking around Japan. Late at night, and like, bro, I'm like this white tourist, so I'm just getting literally harassed by all these people that just want to, like, I don't know what they want. But finally, this girl's like, special massage? I'm like, sure. Sure, I'm in Japan, why not? Let's try a special massage. Let's just say it was a unique service that was a little bit scary and very memorable. No, Japan was so cool. I would just walk around for hours, just let my brain wander. I rented bikes. I walked around like the city. I found some nice views. Sometimes I would just like sit and think for hours and hours. It's very introspective. I'm in a very introspective state right now. Just like for years, years grinding, hustling, outputting, just trying to get good at poker, play good poker, make good poker content. It was nice just to take a couple weeks to be introspective. I really needed it. He raises here flat small blind, which is interesting. This is the 1K. I guess we peel queen four of diamonds. Flop two pair. Here we fucking go. Cards are coming out nice right now. This is like queen 6-5. We're just like really in tough spots. But two pair here is very sexy. Especially small blind fighting range has a lot of ace, queen, king, queen. We see a big bet. This is fucking awesome. This is a really, really good spot right now. In the 1K. I'm just going to shove. I definitely want to raise, but what do I make it like 9 blinds? It just doesn't make sense. And then if he has one pair, he just has to put it in because they can have flush draw so often. But here we go, guys, in the 1K. I'm all in. He calls. What do you got, buddy? Ace king. I have 95%. What the fuck is this? Boom. Wow, he bet calls ace king. Like a champion. Jesus, people are frisky today. I've seen a lot of people put the money in very light. Boom. What a double up in the 1K. Let's go. Register the 1K and we just get this snap double up. That's beautiful. You gotta love that. Gotta love that. It's early. We're not gonna blow our lid just yet, but things are looking really good. Things are looking really good. Dude, I was really sick like last week. I thought it was good. But I went and trained. I went and trained this morning, and like my cough is back. It's horrible. It's really horrible. I went to a jiu-jitsu place, and I hired a one-on-one trainer. I don't like doing the classes, so I hired a guy. I was like, I want your full time and attention. He's like, all right, why'd you come in? And I was like, basically, I've never been in a fight in my life. But if it ever comes to a situation where I need to fight, I just want to have that tool. I want to feel comfortable. You know, if a drunk guy at the bar gets in my face, I will always try to defuse. But if things ever get physical, like, I just want the tools. I want to, like, be able to fight a little bit. He's like, okay, I got you. So we started with boxing today. We put the gloves on, and really good cardio, too. Yeah, this dude's going to train me. It was really fun, too. Big time double in the 1K. You got to love that. Versus, I got it in so good. Button cut off hijack, low jack opens. This is our last hand before break. Show me a four in the 500! No. Sit down. Check here. Okay, let me take a quick little break. I'll be right back. Appreciate y'all for tuning in. If you're on YouTube, can you hit the subscribe button and the like button? Oh my God, what is that turn? It's okay. It's okay. And yeah, if you're on Twitch, you can hit the follow button. I'm going to play some of my recent poker videos. Like, even though I took some time off, I still had some content coming out. What's my break screen look like? No, it's not gonna work. Okay, appreciate everyone tuning in. I'll just be right back, okay?
Before I won reality shows, before I streamed, before I started playing nosebleed cash games, before I won reality shows, before I streamed high stakes poker to thousands of people, oh my God, it all started here in this basement, where I would watch poker legends like Phil Hellmuth and Daniel Negreanu. Today, the legends are in front of me. This is the biggest cash game of my life. I have $100,000. The plan? Win $500,000 or lose it all.
So we hit the ground running.
Kevin Martin with the King 9 suited.
These hands are always decent 3-bet bluffs, and that's the option I take.
Lynn has the Ace Queen suited in the big blind.
Opportunity for our first 4-bet. Exactly what she is counting out.
Thank God. No. Thanks, Lynn.
Lynn G here has bad intentions on her mind.
18?
She puts in the 4-bet, which is absolutely devastating.
Painful, Lynn. Painful.
Have to concede defeat, and right away we're down $7,000 after that bluff gone wrong. This game is wild. It's full of all my favorite poker legends, and we're playing tons of different variations. This is a bomb pot. Everybody gets two cards, and you go right to the flop.
Who's got a five?
Oh,
Negreanu. And Kevin Martin has two jacks.
Eric Hicks bets 2,000. I'm just gonna call. And now Daniel Negreanu raises.
Daniel has been playing insane so far. He's never had a hand, and now the first bomb pot. He has trips. Now,
against a lot of players, maybe I just fold, but Daniel's blasting. He's super rich and he plays cash games so wild. I don't think I can fold. I peel. Turn queen. I don't love this card. He probably has like 9-7, 6-7, these straight draws, or a 5. I'm ready to fold turn, but ooh, he goes this tiny size. He bets 5K. Puts me in an annoying spot. I hate folding to small bets, so I call. River 6. Okay, now I hope he checks like, you know, 6-7, 9-6, something like this.
29K in this pot. Kmart is 30K behind.
I guess I have to check.
Okay.
Two pair.
No good.
Five and you check.
You didn't get that? Betting 5,000 with the
five. Five.
I thought he was setting up the 55,000 river bet.
Yeah. I thought he had a 5 too.
Wow, checks the river.
Horrible, horrible start to this session. We are down a chunk.
Ooh, Kmart with jacks.
Now we're playing this stand-up game. Everybody else has won a hand besides me and Eric Hicks, so we're in danger for having to pay the entire table. Look at this, pocket jacks again. Eric raises. I am absolutely 3-betting and planning to go with my hand. Everybody folds, and I hear the wonderful words.
No.
All of it.
Oh my God.
And the call, and here we go.
All right.
I cannot get my money in fast enough.
Yeah. 60K in the pot.
And to my delight, he is ace 3. This is about as good as it gets. And there's this extra money in the stand-up game. Whoever loses this hand has to pay extra.
That's right. Oh, is it once or twice? It's up to you guys.
Once on.
Yeah.
One.
Okay. I'll run it once.
Please hold.
King 6-6, so far so good for Kmart.
This is a $60,000 pot. I am for sure the poorest person at this table. This is so much money to me.
Ace on the turn. Oh, that stings. I'm miracle jack on the river? No, he cannot.
Miss hand.
Oh, that was painful.
End of game.
Oh, he's broke. He cannot pay us. Sorry. He can't give us a dime each.
This is the most money I've ever been stuck in a poker game. I rebuy. I pay everybody $1,000, but I still have hope. Guess what? We're playing the stand-up game once again, and this time I am not going to lose. Eric Hicks raises, and I have Jack 7 of diamonds. I'm going to 3-bet. Daniel, I didn't realize this at the time, but he was firing off any 2. Is 7-3 suited? The man is crazy. Flop, ace, king, 7. Okay, this should favor my range. I'm the only one who 3-bet pre-flop. This is all me.
A 7 on the flop means a pair of 7s for every single player.
All right. That was a recent YouTube video about my biggest poker loss ever. Welcome back to the stream, everybody. It's great. Got almost 1,000 people watching between the two platforms. Okay, so 500 bounty encore. We're off to a slow start, but we got a clutch double with ladies. And then we just jumped in this 1K mystery bounty. And we got a really nice double up when we flopped 2 pair. Got some chips in the secret bounty over here. Got some chips in a number of places. Let's just take it hand by hand and see how we do. I think I'm going to limp and shove. I could either could raise and plan to play a 4-bet as well. The 10-8 guy bounty tournament here. That guy is a pretty consistent crusher. I'm gonna peel for 1.2. A few barrels, probably have to fold. We also block bluffs like 5-4, 5-8, 5-9. And then we'll just have to muck it. Man has ace king here. 10. Shit. Ah, it's pretty unfortunate in the 54. No problemo. I don't know. Call me crazy. I just sense big things happening here in the 1K mystery bounty. I sense some things happening. We also have some chips here in the lucky 7-7. Let's raise. UTG 7. Yeah, that man just has ace king there. Okay, it's a good flop for me to bet quarter. Obviously, I have a nothing burger here, but king, king, jack is very good for my range. He calls. Turn ace. I really want to have a club or like a 10 to bluff here in general. I also block like 8s and 7s that should fold turn. It's just not a great bluffing hand. I could delayed bluff. Like I could easily check like ace 5 and then bet river, right? I No, I will bluff river. You peeled with like 10-9, queen 9. I will bluff river. It's a pretty good story. Hey, we just hit an ace, we check. Now we bluff the river for... It feels like a reasonable story, right? Even some full houses. Like, I could check ace king on the turn. Doesn't work. Feels like he has a jack. He had an ace. I kind of like my line, though, even though it didn't work. I really kind of like it. Found the open here in the mystery bounty with ace 7. Check back, bluff half pot. Feels kind of clean, actually. The more I think about it, the more I kind of like it. Okay, open A7 off. We go multi-way, which is never what you want to have happen. We just have to check. We have some nice overs. Plus some backdoors like this. Open-ended now. Appreciate you guys tuning in. Again, if you can drop a sub and a like on YouTube, that would be pretty cool. This guy leads small blind. Kind of surprising. Big blind has more threes than small blind. I'm going to call. Put a three or an eight out there. King, you. Definitely kind of you. You bet into three people too. Okay, we open this in the 500. In the low jack. Poker game feels all right today. He say 7. Just quarter pot it here and be pretty excited about it. Ace Ace X is just one of the best boards for the original opener. Nice. Okay, open button, big blind defense. Queen 8-7. I think my best eights here do want to bet most of the time. Dude, I'm rusty. I gotta get back into some study. I will. I've also been making training videos for Run It Once, you guys. If you're a Run It Once member, there's two published. I got a series of 12 coming out. Reviews are really good. People are really liking what I have to say. I'm gonna be pretty aggressive with the barrel here. Like, he just really can't fold an 8 or a 7 to a second bet. Most of his queens should check raise flop as well. So let's barrel. Nice. 250 pay here, long ways to go. This is the 1K mystery bounty, 655 started. Definitely gonna open the 5-4 suited here with the bounty covering small blind as well. It's been a nice little session so far. Hopefully we can just kind of crush it here. How's my year going? I haven't played a ton of poker. 3 bets off a small stack. Shallow, this hand just does really badly. We're just going to fold. The 500 here is the one of the main events along with the 1K. I really do feel like we might final table something big today. Kind of have that feeling. Ooh, this is interesting. He raises, I flat, and this guy calls with just like a couple bigs behind. Just probably going to be a bounty in play here. King queen suited, it's such a good hand. All this action though, $17, 26, 17. God, do I just rumble with it here? This is like pretty strong. I'll be conservative. It just feels like there's strength. Feels like I have to be dominated here in one of these spots. Tens, aces. A good fold. I would have had a chance for a triple bounty, but... Okay, small blind limps. Want to be a little polar in this spot, meaning I can raise hands that can go to war and then raise hands that I don't mind folding. This is kind of a nice hand to check back. It's a really good board for me. I'm going to have more deuces here, because he's going to walk out hands like 3-deuce and 7-deuce. It's quite a good board here. I do get to do a lot of betting, and I will. Two overs, some backdoor clubs. He check raises. I do think I'm going to float here. I don't really think he has many medium pairs. Those are probably not going to limp all that often. So he has like some really gnarly traps. I float and we turn really good. It's another good card for my range. Now I have gut shot clubs. The 105 secret mystery bounty. Showing a lot of strength here. Check raising flop, barreling turn. Green card, please. Ooh. What a nice run out here. This man does not have a full house. Like, he's not going to check raise 5-5, 3-3. Not a lot of, like, 7-deuce combos. What a run out. Come on. I really think he's a 5, like king 5, ace 5, even like 6-5. I have a feeling we're going to get paid here. How could he airball this spot? No, he's going to pay. He's going to pay. Yeah, he has something. Ah, 3-bet bluffing. Pretty good combo to choose. It's a little bit scary because we're covered in a PKO. But this man opens low jack with the chip lead. I'm just going to 3-bet the ace-9 off. Mr. Diago. If you watch my run it once video, I explain why this is a potentially a really good 3-bet spot. Oh, man. Oh, man. Damn, he kind of cooks me here. When somebody's range is polar, the 4-bet click just works so well just because they have that trash. Fuck. Let's do some shoutouts in the chat. Who's chilling? What up, Juste? What up, Lightning Soul? Fly Fisher? Jost Saja? Ukrainian? VIP Legal? What's up, everybody? Thank you for tuning in. Some people are talking about the Alberta poker scene. Alberta's a great live poker scene. Again, I went and played some Calgary tournaments the start of January, and I just played it, and the vibe was off. I was like, get me out of here. It was like crazy main events and high rollers and stuff, but I just took off to Japan. I just wasn't in the right mindset. And I'm really glad. Some people are like, oh, you should just be grinding, but dude, I'm in a place with my career where like, when I'm just not feeling it, like, I'm gonna go explore the world, and then I mean, I'm going to grind and create content 80% of the time, but got to take those breaks, dude. Especially someone like me, I just got to take those breaks. In the past, I ignored those signs and kind of got whacked. Going to open 9-8 suited here. This is the 1K. Open UTG 7. Take it down. Blind on blind here. He limps, I check. I did bet the flop. Now turn's going to go check, check. Should have more threes. Do I win? Oh, I do. Nice. It's a good win. Cutoff opens in the 1K. You have a standard cutoff opening range here, like offsuit nines and stuff. Let's defend. Really good flop, top pair plus the gut shot. Having the jack of diamonds is nice as well. Jack 9-9. I have a straight. It's gonna be very aggressive in this spot. Setting up a river shove. Maybe I should bet a little smaller with the jack in my hand because that block is continues. And if I just have a single 10 without a pair, I'd bet a little bigger. That would make a little bit of sense, but well, that's fine. Not sure about that play. Drinking some Rungu juice here. Orange and turmeric kombucha. Fermented sparkling beverage. This is pretty close here. I'm just going to fold. Come on. Cutoff opens here. Let's defend off at 28. Bad gut shot. It's really a marginal kind of gut shot here. Gonna continue for third. Double gutter. Ooh, big pot here. It's weird. This guy kind of min three bet. He could definitely have like a big hand here. I'm just going to be all in. Feels like he has kings. He has kings. Boo. Okay, now I got aces here. Let's play the small three bet. Tough 9-high flop there. He induced me. Okay, this is the 54. I got aces. Cover this original opener. Come on. Stuff it in. Beautiful. That is interesting. Now you can put it in. I think I just put it in. Who puts in 10K here and ever folds? Like, it's just never a thing, right? Who would ever put in 10K here and find the fold? Don't tell me this guy's folding. If he 4-bet folds off of 21 bigs, he might be the best player ever. All right. Chance for a bounty. Let's go. One pair is enough for you, my friend. You don't need any more of those. Oh, a lot of clubs as well, but we're playing defense here. Fade it. Good. Yes, I have a set. $12.50 bounty. Yo, we're collecting a lot of bounties here in the 54. Basically, free rolling. I think that's our fourth minimum bounty. Aces do their job. Beautiful. I thought that guy might fold. I was like, just like, no shot, bro. Come on! Sunday action. Still got 20 bigs here, but that 3-bet with ace-9 was costly. This guy's all in. If somehow it folds to me, I'll take a shot at it, but somebody's gonna hunt him. Here we go again on my own. Down the only road. Have you guys been missing the stream? I've low-key been missing the stream. I've low-key been missing this a little bit. It's interesting. When I'm streaming, I just get to come live for like 8 hours. But then like sometimes we just put so much effort into like a 10-minute YouTube video. Dude, it's so devastating when you put so much time and effort into a YouTube video and then it just like bombs. You're like, oh man. I love all of it, dude. I love the, like the reels on Instagram we've been making lately. I love the, like streaming. It's good. I got options. That's why I've been really introspective lately. Just trying to figure it out. I've just been really taking some time doing a lot of thinking, a lot of journaling. Just really trying to figure out like what direction I want to go. It will definitely involve poker and making money through poker. But like, I could be a streamer, I could be a YouTuber. I could do more coaching, like Run It Once videos, you know what I mean? Okay. We're in the 500 here. It's the only person we cover for a bounty. I have ace jack. I think I have to take it. What's his shoving range here? Probably like fives plus, ace 10, king queen suited. Yeah, if I didn't cover him, I would fold, but we get a chance at a bounty here with ace jack. I think this is a hand we just take. Oh, wow. Sixes, ace queen. Show me a jack. There's a jack. Wow, that's a really good jack. Let's fade it. Holy fuck, that's a really good jack on the flop. No queen, no six. Boom! 125 bounty, and that's a big fat fucking stack. Come on! Massive, 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 massive hand there. That is a massive hand of no limit hold'em. Let's go! Boom! Gives us 60 bigs, and we got a chance now. I saw the sixes, we're okay versus the sixes. I saw the ace queen, we're in very bad shape versus the ace queen. But the jack attack. Fuck yeah, man. Massive. That's huge. Beautiful. Now we just got some ammo here. We got 60 bigs, we got the 125 bounty that just all helps massively. Huge. Couple of jacks in the encore. And let's go up to the aces here in the 105 mystery bounty. Jacks, raise and take, no action. Wow. He min raises off of 11. I guess I just call, like. Of course I just call, but. My flat here looks really suspicious. Hopefully it's a 105 and nobody's paying attention. We gotta just call, right? Here I go again. Oh, baby, we trapped him. Oh, baby! This is just a glorious spot. This is a Kodiak moment. Take a picture of this. Does he put the money? Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. This is the, look at this. Look at this. This is for a massive stack in the 105. This is gorgeous. I'll put it in. This cold call here is just so good too. It adds so much value to the pot. Wow, three people are in. Are you in too, sir? Oh, four way all in. Queens, jacks. What the fuck is this? What is this? Are you kidding me, bro? What is this hand? What is this hand? I think I have side pots here. What is this hand? Aces, kings, queens, and jacks. And the man flops quads. I was like, what is going on? I actually come away really nice with the side pots. What was that? Bro, I haven't played online poker in a long time. I don't remember like seeing this shit. That's a hell of a hand there. I was like, what is this? Aces, kings, queens, jacks. That was a special one. Truly special stuff there. Okay, I got some chips in the 500 now. Got that booty as well. I think I started the hand with 80k. I think I started the hand with 80k, 89k, and I came out with 133. This man just flops quads. What a life. The min raise looks suspicious. My flat looks suspicious. This guy three bets. He cold calls. He shoves. I shove. Call, call. Like, what was that? That was nuts. I don't know, I've seen aces, kings, queens. I don't know if I've seen aces, kings, queens, jacks. Literally. I don't know if I've ever seen that before. I played a lot of poker. That was bizarre. Okay, GG opens. It's flat here. It opens off at 35. I flop trips. Trip jacks. His bottom opens. He's not going to have queen jack off. That's a little too wide. He'll have king jack off, ace jack. He bets small. Going to play call. We have the nuts. I hope he has ace-jack or king-jack now. Honestly, him betting small on this board is like really encouraging. I think I might check this exact combo. No, let's bet small. Let's bet a size where if he has ace-king, ace-queen, but why would that c-bet flop? Yeah, let's just bet. Let's just bet. Like, when he bets this flop, he's normally going to have something. And it's really hard to fold something for third pot. Let's not go for all of it. Let's just go for half. Pretty important to get paid in these spots. The nuts. Nice. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful hand there. 75K. We could do some damage in this bounty encore now. Do you have a link for One Run at Once Coaching? No, I don't have an affiliate link with them. They obviously paid me for the videos. But yeah, you guys, if you guys want to, we should put a link up or whatever. It's called Blue Collar Poker Theory. Like I take GTO basically. It took me, GTO was really overwhelming for me and I didn't really understand it. And I put in so many hours. And then I try to take it and explain it like I'm telling it to a five-year-old basically. Like really down to earth, like really try to explain it very easily. People have really liked my training videos so far. We're just going to call here. I'm flush. Making some hands right now. We're making some hands. Hitting some cards. I can't wait to see the reaction for the aces, kings, queens head. It was just so nuts. Checks back. Like I guess I just go big. Nice, we get paid. Chat, look at this, look at chat here. Aces, kings, queens, jacks. I did lose the main pot. That was just so out of line. You rarely see shit like that. The man just flops quads too, like. Guys, join us. Really nice session here so far. We are doing well in the 1K mystery bounty. We late regged and instantly doubled up. Got some chips here. We're free rolling the 54. Got some chips on the 105. Got a nice stack in the 500 with a bounty. Just playing our best. A little bit rusty. I haven't played much poker in the last like 20 days. Just been traveling the world. It does feel like we're back in a big way though. Nothing here. Do I want to bluff with the Jack 10 and diamonds? He snap checks. Nah. I think I got a shove here. 7.7. Sucks with the bounty, but. Not looking very good. Maybe we can triple up here. Wow. Spades, I guess. Dead. Dead to the field. Okay, GG the 77. Chat, we all got a good laugh over that hand. That was fucking crazy. Okay, 1K. Dude, this thumbs up and thumbs down thing is honestly like kind of annoying. I think GG should just take it out. Okay, it says Kmart, big fan. Keep up the good work. Yeah, appreciate you. Okay, open here versus big blind. Just do a lot of betting on ace, jack, deuce. He calls. Don't like this card. He's going to have more flushes out of the big blind. You know. Feels like we just like never win, right? Feels like we rarely ever win. I don't know. Like, it's always tough to know what to bluff in those spots. Guy raise, call, flop checked around. Kind of just want to show this one down. 1,000 people pay. When 1,000 people pay, the mystery bounty will be in play too. 3.7 from Andre Novak. Don't think we can fold this for half pot, although it's uncomfortable. Mr. Novak. Ah, he got a nice little value bet in. Okay, back to the 1K. Raise King Queen from under the gun. UTG 8. When I say UTG 8, it just means under the gun on an 8 player table. Promo King flat small blind. Interesting. Three napkins for me. Gonna be quite passive on 4-4-3. Turn a king. It's the flush completer. About getting check raised, but I still think betting here is gonna be the play. No ace king really from either spot. Never has a four. The jack's a little worrisome, like king jack, obviously. Hard room to have a worse king. Like, does he even flat king nine? I don't know. It's gonna make like a really nitty check, I guess. A really nitty check. I knew the jack was bad, bro. It's like there's so few. Like, he could have king jack or king 10, you know what I mean? So it's like, it's a really well played hand by me, honestly. Like, for me to bet turn and then just like check river and just be like, I don't know. It's a really well played hand. That river check is like really kind of top tier, I think. Button cut of hijack, low jack open scale. We're going to defend off of 26. Tenny Ducey. Lost a series of small ones in the 1K, no problem. Still a big stack in the 500. We did get that one bounty, which is nice as well. God, it feels really good to be playing some poker right now. Hello, everybody on YouTube and Twitch. Hope you guys have been doing well. If you're on Twitch, can you drop me a follow? If you're on YouTube, just drop me with a subscription for free. Big year coming up. I'm excited for all of it. What exactly is it going to look like? To be determined, kind of. Let's start with a big hit here on Sunday. Nice, like 30, 40K something. Okay, cutoff opens. Defend the king four. These boards are very bad out of the big blind. They're very good for the in position player. Also got this bubble looming here. What's the big bounty? The biggest bounty is 40k. Can we hit a big bounty today? That would be so fun. That would really be kind of enjoyable. What's the big bounty in the 1k mystery bounty? 50k. I'm going to open off a 16 here. This is a really good open hand. If I have king queen, I kind of just want to shove, right? But if I raise and get action, I can fold king 10 pretty happily. So kind of have a polar min-raising strategy, and this is like a really good, basically min-raise bluff. A flat from Bubby. It's been a little bit tighter in a call in the big blind. Queen 8 deuce, all spades. We have the 10 of spades. I check a lot on this board anyway. Just kind of in no man's land with my exact hand. Might just fold, man. Might just fold, like. Spade's not particularly that great. He bets into three people. Kind of a tough spot. I'm going to bluff a big with eight high. Nice. When you bluff one big blind and win the pot, it always feels good. Couple of ladies on the button. This is the super six. I don't really love turbos as much, but the six-handed is nice. I think my food is here. Oh, that's a good flop. To get my food. And I was like, bro, I have quads. The dude was taking forever. I'm like, bro, I'm playing all my poker. I was like, sweet. I give up, he says. I'll show him the quads. A good give up. That was a good give up by him. I had four queens. I ordered Swiss Chalet chicken wings, which are the best kind. Hot chicken wings from Swiss Chalet. Okay, 700 away from the bubble. I'm just going to rip. Ace King off this stack is going to be a shove. Hoping for some action, but. Novak. That's the ace queen off if I've ever seen it. Ace jack suited. I get it in good. Ooh, what a flop too. Takes away some of his outs. Boom! Big time bubble with the big time double with the bubble looming. That's great. So good. Okay, flop a flush draw here. Alex limps the button. I flop a 6-high flush draw. I don't think I get to be aggressive out of the big here with such a wide range. Do I call? I think so, just the implied odds. I'm like, he either has a 10 or a bluff and he's gonna fire the river a lot. So on a spade, I think I might be able to get it, so I will call. That's not a spade. Dude, that was so stressful. I'm trying to get my chicken wings and the guy's like fumbling with the bag, fumbling with the zipper. I'm like, bro, I'm playing online poker. He's like, what? Okay, a couple ladies. This is in the 500 encore. Cover these guys. Jacob. Queen, queen. I'm going to go 3.5x out of position. So that's 7. I don't know, like 8.2 or something. And let's get some action, preferably from him, 187 bounty. Get through at this spot with a somewhat polar range. I got queens, bro. Queens versus jacks. Good matchup here. This is a big pot. Deuce. Oh, what a cooler for my favor here. Red or blue is good. Boom! What a fucking setup, boys and girls. What a setup. 187 bounty. Massive and a massive, massive stack now. Wow. Queens versus jacks. That is an absolute setup in my favor. Beautiful. So I already got 312 in bounties now, which is so great. Jump up to the 1K. I am just going to play a call. That's a shit flop. Queens versus jacks. That was fucking sexy, man. Jump up to the 1K. We're up to 100,000. We've been losing a series of small pots, but it's all good. I got ace 10 here. 20 bigs. Ooh, ace king in the 500 now, and there's some shorties. 250 bounty here. This is a really good stack. A bunch of shorties. Man, do I ever overtrap here? Wow, I'm gonna do something really weird because of this guy. I'm gonna do something really weird. There's potential here and then here. Come on, put it in, Clickwork. I need you to put it in, all in. Fuck, he just calls. Oh, baby! There's the trap. Oh my goodness, you guys. Okay. Need the church to come in clutch here. Really need the church to come in clutch here. Massive fucking hand with my best hand. Oh, how does he fold? So sick. Threes and queen 10 off. Church, baby. Jack. Ace. I think I win the main. He had more chips than him. Okay, we get 187. Perfect. We win the side is what I mean. We win the side. We win the side. Boom! 187 bounty. I mean, it's not the full scoop, but... It's not the full scoop. 187 bounty is pretty good, though. And then here, this is a really interesting spot where... This is in the 1K. He can value shove worse. He can bluff a whole bunch of hands. He bet flop and turn. We just win in the 1K. Come on, man. Bluff it in there, bro. Man, that was so interesting in the 1K. Queen 10. Fucking Queen 10, bro. He limp called it off. Alex Theogis is a legend. That was a weird play. Come on, Clickwork. Put it in now. This dude's trolling over here with his bounty. Really bad flop. Really big river to win the side pot, honestly. I will call if he shoves. Although I wouldn't be that excited about it. Pretty good flop here. Button cut off hijack opens. I'm going to be a little wide here just because of this click work situation. Lots of action on the stream. You gotta love it. Lot of action. A lot of action, a lot of big pots. Turn 5's pretty shit this deep. He's gonna have more 5x. I'm gonna check back and then play for one street on the river. And then he gets to bluff with his like queen 10, his 7-8 that didn't check raise. He also seems like he's in a feisty mood, so let's check back and do this. I do think this guy just, like, can't help himself, and he's definitely going to lead a lot on the river. On the turn, excuse me. Do I play raise? Let me think about it. Oh my god, we get it in really good here. $50 bounty. It's very good bounty here in a small tournament. We're going to chop. Fuck, I'm such a little bitch. I should raise, but I don't have it in me. I should always raise that spot. I know I should. What a run here in the 500. 500 in bounties. Look, I fold. Don't put it in now, click. Ah, so sick. I had so many chances for him to put it in. So sick. Break in 1 minute. I'm going to eat some chicken wings. I really hope you survive, buddy. Dun, dun, dun. Queen 8, Queen 8. It's a good spot with aces. He was really tight with the short stack. He finds aces. And they both have Queen 8. It's good card removal to see. Alright, that was a lot of action. My goodness. Appreciate you guys. That was a lot of fun. We got some really good spots. I'm going to take a little break. I'm going to play our recent YouTube video. And yeah, good shit, man. Really good shit. I appreciate everybody tuning in. Again, if you can hit me with the sub and the follow, it's all free. Greatly, greatly appreciated. Good stuff, man. I'll be right back. Cheers.
How does that card come,
right?
I bet, and to my absolute disgust, I get called by both players. This is not good. Turn a 10. There's a time to give up in poker, and sometimes you need to put your balls on the table. I am going to win this pot.
It's a gut shot now to that pair of sevens, but he is concerned. He thinks that someone has perhaps an ace, king,
I bet, and both players fold. Turns out I had the best hand, but this is such a ballsy move with the jack blocker. We win, I get a sit down. It looks like it's going in the right direction.
Eric had him for sure.
Yeah, come on. And here it is, the biggest poker hand I've played in my entire life. I'm looking for some big hands and I find one. Ace, king on the button, the church. Here we go, let's pump it. Now I wish I raised bigger. I should have made it like 5K or something. I should have went way bigger. This is way too small and I pick up a bunch of callers. Flop, king, 8-2, all spades. I know I have the ace of spades, amazing. Top pair and the nut flush draw. I'm expecting it to check to me. I was the three better preflop, but Daniel leads and it really confuses me. I know he's kind of tilting away here, playing a ton of hands, but what does this mean? The world is my oyster. I could raise, get the money in, I could call.
Grano has been so crazy and active in this game. Kevin Martin must feel like he's got the whole world.
I decide on the passive action. Turn, four of diamonds. That doesn't help me at all. And I'm expecting him to continue, and sure enough, he does. But the size shocks me. He bets massive. He bets 25,000.
That is half of Kevin Martin's stack, that 25,000 chip bet. Martin wondering, what in the world does he have? Did he flop a smaller flush? Somehow two pair? And he understands if he shoves now, he just has to get called. Negreanu has to call him.
But this is Daniel. He's been blasting. Fuck it. We live, we die. Here we go.
And he does indeed shove.
How much? I guess I have to call. I call. How many times do you want to do it? Or I don't know if I have the best one.
We can discuss.
Okay. He's ahead, but like, look at the outs. 40%.
Look at all the outs for Kmart. Up to you, buddy. 17
outs.
They run it once or twice.
Nice. Guys, I started playing $5 tournaments. Here I am in a $128,000 US dollar pot against my poker idol. Regardless of what happens, bro, we fucking made it, man. What a spot to be in. But please, one time, guys, subscribe to this channel. Maybe we can scoop here. This is the biggest pot of my life.
Two times, let's run it.
Okay, they'll run it twice.
Spade, spade, please.
$128,400 in the middle.
Eight or?
Nah, man. It's just like, I didn't think the single king was good, but.
Well, I can't hold on. Yeah, you're just gonna get it in.
First run out. That's all Daniel. Kmart needing a spade, an ace, an eight, or a four.
It'd be good.
Really good track.
Fucking hell. That's too bad. GG's, eh?
Misses everything.
Oh man, that's tough.
Sometimes it's just not meant to be. In this video, I'm playing heads up versus one of the wildest poker personalities in the whole industry. Sashimi Poker is so outrageous. And I have beef with her. She beat me in this $25,000 pot. I got it in drawing dead, and she needled the shit out of me.
Nice hands, Sashimi.
Thank you. You too.
I never forgot it. Sashimi! Today is about revenge.
We've each put up $2,000 of our own money. It's a 4K heads up match. And we're gonna battle to the death today. I need to win. 13. Chip leader. You win.
Chip leader.
Now, Sashimi is a good cash game player. I don't know if she knows how to play heads up, though. I've worked a lot on heads up. This is episode 2. I need a W. I'm 0-1 in this series, and it's game time.
Call. 3-bet pot.
3-bet pot.
Starting it off spicy.
Please, shit. Mm. Oh, that's me. 4.
You are the chip leader now.
I am a chip leader.
Fuck, how do I miss so hard? I have such a good hand.
What was the camera?
Sashimi poker.
What was that? What was that? Was that a, I saw a deuce in there.
That was a fun video with Sashimi. Quite a bit of content got left on the cutting floor that was just like a little bit too R-rated. All right. Okay, good shit. Got some really good stacks. Just gonna take it slow. 1K stack here. And this 500 stack is looking mighty, mighty fine. Late reg still open. How many people are gonna pay? 15-ish? Got some good cards in our favor so far. 400 away from the money here. I just have 16 bigs. Let's do some shoutouts in the chat. Lightning Soul. Zhuang. I don't think the 3 shove was that bad, actually. What up, Julian? What up, Bugatti Peak? What up, Frosky? Gotta say, I'm really enjoying the session today. Oh man, this guy finally got the 250 bounty. It's a really juicy bounty. 187 here, 125 here. That guy had like 2 bigs with a huge bounty forever. Here we go again on my own. I ate some chicken wings. Dude, I'm telling you guys, at least in Canada, if you want the best chicken, I've eaten all the chicken wings in Calgary. Chicken wings, one of my favorite foods. Swiss Chalet hot chicken wings. I'm not even crazy about Swiss Chalet, but something about their chicken wings, unbelievable. Like the texture, they're crispy, the flavor, it's all there across the board. A to Z, check, 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 check. It's just a beautiful creation. Raising ace-5 suited down here in the 54. Monotone board. I think we do bet quarter here. Just get him to fold like queen-6 of spades. But I got the GG nuts. Now, I haven't played much online poker lately. But this hand has always been invincible. Wow, promo king with a lot of chips here. Kind of hijack. Low jack raises off a 17, and this is a hand we shove. If he folds, it's great. If he calls, we will trust the GG nuts. In the 1K. He's gonna have a lot of offsuit Broadway opens here, though. He calls. Okay. This is where this hand usually wins. It's a really good start. Keep it low, dealer. Keep it low with no counterfeits. Small card. Small card. Spade's really good. Boom! What a flip! What a fucking flip in the 1K. Let's go! Massive! The GG nuts. They're still as good as I remember. Okay, I got some situations here. I'm gonna shove this one. If I have ace-8, ace-9 suited, they're better as defense. Ace-5 is just gonna really print with the reshove here, and this is 300 away from the money. I'm just gonna take it and be pretty happy with it. Ooh, he does find the call. Hopefully that's just king queen. He took a long time. Ace-5, ace-5. Diamonds. Ooh, free roll for me. Oh, do it! Do it! Ah. Okay, this guy raises UTG, just decided to defend ace queen. Definitely gonna continue with two overs, ace of spades. This is in the 500. Big time fucking flip there with the sevens. It's a really good card for my hand. I'm also gonna have more jack nine in general. I'll have jack nine suited, but not the offsuit combos. Now with this hand, I think I just wanna check and just like try to beat like ace nine or ace jack. I think we just have enough showdown to check it. Ace queen high. That's a winner. That's a winner. We're rolling right now. The kid is starting to feel it a little bit. Big time flip in the 1K. Big time stack in the 500. Bubble closing in up here. Sashimi looks nice. Have you ever thought about asking her out? No. No, I have not. I have a poker rivalry with her. What do I do with this hand? King 8 suited. I think I want to shove this one. Four bigs there. Yeah, we're going to play the rip. Getting through him is really good. There's also an opportunity cost. He calls. King 8 suited. Okay, we're live. Sexy and live. That's a very bad start. Ew. Oh. Four outs. Maybe. Damn. That sucks. 300 away from the money. I still like the shove. Still like the shove. It's gonna be profitable. It does suck near the money, but I don't know. The min cash is so shit too. Let's see if we can spin it up. How many people are gonna pay in the 1K mystery bounty? 125-ish. Grips, what's up, bro? My man Grips. Dude, I was thinking about you the other day.
Welcome back, Browski. Hope you had a great time in Japan, my dude.
Shout out Grips. Just hit 100,000 subs on YouTube, which is an amazing achievement. I have yet to do so. Hopefully we'll do so somewhat soon. Grips, appreciate that, man, with the 65 months. It's awesome, bro. Appreciate that. Dude, YouTube's so hard to make good content. To get good thumbnails, titles, do so consistently. Appreciate your Grips. Thank you very much for the 65-month resub. Open this bitch up. We got Alex Fox in here. The Foxinator. He was just tweeting about how he doesn't play online poker anymore. He doesn't trust it. And here he is, playing some online poker. I got 2.7 bigs here, trying to spin. Do I take the queen nine? No, I'm gonna have a better hand in the next three, I think, right? Damn, so brutal. To get called there, and then we're super live versus ace 10. Ace 6 off, I'll just fold. Fold with the queen 9, and it's pretty... Oh, I was gonna say it's a pretty good fold, but then I would have flopped the nizzles. Wow, how does that hand win on the flop? This guy flops. Wow, what is his equity on the flop? It's like, he's like dead. I guess I'm all in next hand. trying to spin, but it's not looking very good, man. It's really not. Nobody's that short on this table anymore. What was this, raise and shove? Ooh. That's a brutal bad beat. $300 bounty and a huge stack. Ace 9 just gets there. Now he's kind of short with a 250 bounty. Let's stop and go him. I got a pair. Fold. Oh, wow. He's dead. How does he have 10 deuce here? Why would he raise 10 deuce when I'm committed with any two? Okay, we got six bigs. Opens 10 deuce off cutoff with me being all... That was one of the strangest opens I've ever seen. I'm committed with any two, and he opens the Doyle. Okay, got a chance. Got a chance with five bigs. That was a very generous play by him. Really quite generous. Okay, 54 bounty encore. I have the delicious overs and open-ended. I don't cover either player, though. I've done pretty well in this tournament in bounties. $54 buy-in. God, you just shove? That's so annoying. I just have to fold, right? That's so tilting. Does the spin story continue here? That was a fucking crazy open. I still can't get over it. Foxen somehow gets toasted by the aces. That's why he doesn't like online poker. A rebot. Okay, gonna open low jack here. 1k mystery bounty. Opening into the heart of the chip leader. Got a really good shove spot here with the spin up story for five bigs. With ace 10. Spin up story. This guy snaps. Snaps so aggressively. Oh my goodness, we get it in so good. Come on! We've got a chance to make the money now. I was so dead. We were all in the big blind and now we have 12 bigs. I really do think I should bluff this card with this hand. If we get check shoved on, it's like really painful. But I think if you use a queen, it's... Really good bluff here in the 1k, really good bluff. Let's keep the train going, queen jack suited. UTG 8. I like this, I gotta like this flop. Top pair and a flush draw. Let's play a bet. have the whole world. All right, let's slide in the check range now. Not too many hands I lose to. Don't really see queens plus ever here. Definitely see some tens, some sevens, 8-9 suited full combos. Jack 10 just suited, and there's only like one combo left. Pretty hard for him to have a 7. Just gonna check call. I don't know why. My instincts is saying check call. So brutal if he checks back like 10-9 though. Somewhat hard for him to have a 10. Oh, man. Oh, damn. Put a heart out there. I'm going to fuck that hand up. And by might of it, I really think I probably missed some money there. I had to, bro. How does no more money get in? Should I just bet the river? It's kind of hard for him to have a 10, though. He had a 10. It's so sad. I will call a shove here with the ace 9. It's going to rip all of his worst aces, like ace 2, ace 3, ace 4, ace 5, all this shit. Ace 9, I think we just power shove. We load up the clip and shove it all in. Like that, we're up to where we're low key cooking here a little bit in the 1K. 1K mystery bounty. 500. Things are looking really nice. Let's go over here. I bet flop turn is just gin. Now we just triple it off. If I go half, that's call 9K, 18 in the middle with like 15 behind. Badoogie board, so we don't have to front load it. So let's just go this and shove a lot of rivers. Seems good to me. Meanwhile, in the 1K, I limp, he checks. I'm in a barrel here. I have a really good bluff candidate. I have a gut shot, low equity hand, plus the ace of spades, eight of spades. Kind of a really, really good barrel candidate here. I like it. Now I'm pretty sure I just want to give up on the river. Although he can never have queen 10, and he can never have 8-10. Having the spade is pretty bad, but we are pretty bottom of range now, where I think I am just going to bluff. Just his absence of 8-10 and queen 10 is like pretty significant. Having the spade is pretty bad. Boom! We get a bluff through with 8 high. Massive. Okay, raise, he shoves. I think I'm just going to put the middle in. I cover that. Here we go, guys. Here we go. Hopefully Alex or this guy doesn't wake up with something. But even if he does, I cover. Here we go, guys. 125 bounty. That's a good hand to see. It's a really good hand to see. It's a very bad flop to see. It's a very bad flop to see. It's a very poor turn to see. It's a very poor turn to see. River. It's shit. It's all shit. Too bad. Would have loved to add that bounty. What a play here in the 1K, though. What a play. The kid is... look, I won 4 in a row. I won 4 in a row. Bluffed here. I think I fucked up that one hand. He opens UTG7. A little bit of 3-betting. A lot of flat. Let's talk to our buddy Eugene. Okay, we'll just flat. We'll just flat. And what do we do over here? We've had a massive spin up where we have 10 bigs on the button, on the bubble. Flat. I flop really good. He bets. I call. A lot of action. Bet's big. He opened UTG 7. A little bit scary. We'll have a bunch of Jack 9 suited, Queen 9 suited. Queen Jack suited, Ace Jack, Ace Queen. Can't fold here. Bricks out. He checks, which is really good. Super polar when he pots the turn. Just gotta decide whether I want to value shove or not. I just don't think he like has much worse. He either has air or yeah, I'm just gonna check. I think I win, but I'm not gonna value bet this river. Because of his turn size, he polarizes his range.
Enjoy watching your streams, curse lit.
Massive hand. Massive fucking hand in the 1K. Come on! 70 bigs. 70 fucking fat ones right now. Yo, appreciate it. Solid star with the resub. Thank you. Appreciate that a lot. Let's keep it going. Let's open this bitch up! We're feeling it right now. Come on, Alex. You gotta kill my vibe like that. Okay, let's open the fours down here in the 500. Good stack. I think 50k starting stack. We have almost 300. I raise, Krill 3 bets. Oh, we're definitely going to see a flop. I'm fucking hot right now. We're definitely going to see a flop here in the 500. Four bigs for a four.
Hey Kevin, thank you for the hoodie you sent me. Smile, wish you the best of luck today.
Hey, no problem. Glad you're enjoying the merch. 84 months. Jesus, no fold them. That's insane. Thank you so much. That's insane. 84 months. Okay, 54. Get it in good here. I do feel like I'm going to lose this one, though. Which is okay. It's a small buy-in. It's all good. It's all good, we can lose that one. Hey, oh, hey. I just knew I was gonna lose that one. Very close to the money here. Excuse me, bro. Dude, those are deep, like, horrible coughs. It's really horrible. We got the ace deuce. Big Smoke says he's playing some good poker. Trying, bro. Trying. Okay, so down here we're 16 to 33, 15 pay. Not too worried about that till we get close to the bubble. I do have $500 locked up, which is really positive. We got a big fat stack in the mystery bounty. we might as well tank here. We're 50 away from the money. Ooh, got a big hand here. Play raise first in with this one, I think. 34 bigs effective. What a run in the 1K. We just need to hit the money with a big stack and get the secret bounty. That's what we need. Ooh, I was probably going to chill to the money. But 40 off the money, I will go all in with ace-queen suited, that's for sure. This is the 105 secret bounty. I want to get my little fingers inside those gold chests today. All in. Any action? 40 off the money. No. Okay, 1K got a really beautiful flat in hand here, ace 10 suited. PDC Mayor. Should find a polar bluff here. Definitely gonna take a flop here. Definitely gotta see three cards here with the ace 10 suited. Okay, very interesting. I'm super capped on this board, but with a shallow stack to pot size ratio, you might even just rip the ace queen pre. Obviously, this ace ace one combo, king king three combos. I am going to call. You don't really see me getting away from this hand, honestly. Do I just check raise here versus the small bet? I kind of don't want his like free stuff to get free equity. Okay, let's just like check raise and we're gonna go with this hand. Cool, that sure, that works with me. That works with me. That's great, why not? To win that three bet pot there, sure. That's great. Hey Kevin Martin, let's have a fucking night tonight. Let's do it, brother. Kmart, you're playing with emotion. Yeah, a little bit of emotion's good. I'm kind of fired up right now. I'm really into it. Okay, we're 20 off the money. $330 here, it's really juicy. Late reg ending. Ooh, a couple of aces in the 500. 31 remain. Nobody's really short for a bounty. This guy. Let's open up the aces. How to check flats cut off. It's really scary to check this one. Ace ace no spade. We only lose to sets 8-9 suited, two combos from each player. I got a bet. Maybe ace ace with a spade. You can convince me to check, but I'm gonna bet this one. Okay, it's really clean. We have a high equity hand. We're just not gonna give like queen 10, jack 10 a free river. We're just hammering in here. I don't know what else to say. We're gonna live or die with these aces. We're going to live or die with these aces. If I bet 20, he calls at 70 in the middle. About two thirds on river. Sure. Okay. Back up over 100 here. It's a good win. Obviously, you just have dreams of the Mirage when you have the aces, but it's a